Hello students, welcome to the session. So in this session today we are going to see about the arrhythmia. So arrhythmia is nothing but the irregular heartbeat. So before going to see about the what is irregular heartbeat, so just in brief we are going to see about the what is normal rhythm of the heart. So in this slide we are going to see the normal rhythm of the heart. So heart rate is nothing but the amount of beat that is or the mechanical activity that is taking place in the heart, that is called as the heart rate, and it should be around 60 to 100 beats per minute. So that is the heart rate of the normal rhythm of the heart, and the heartbeat should be originating from the SA node. So here the pacemaker of the normal individual's heart should be from the SA node, and the impulses which are originated from the SA node should pass through the normal conduction pathway. That is, the from the SA node the impulses should pass to the AV node through the internodal fibers, and from the internodal fibers to the bundle of His, and from the bundle of His the impulses should transfer to the Purkinje fibers. So that is the normal conduction pathway. So if it is like that, then it is called as the normal rhythm of the heart. And the velocity of the impulse transfer should be moderate velocity in the atrium, and the slow velocity in the AV node. So when it moves from the atrium to the AV node, the impulse's velocity should be slow in AV node, and when it passes to the bundle of His, from the AV node when it passes to the bundle of His, the velocity of the impulses should be high. So that is the normal velocity of the normal rhythm of the heart. So the normal rhythm of the heart rate should be around 60 to 100 beats per minute, and heartbeat should be originating from the SA node, and the impulses that is originated from the SA node should pass through the normal conduction pathway, and the normal velocity should be in the atrium should be, it should be a moderate velocity, and in AV node that is the slow velocity, and in the bundle of His the velocity should be high. So that is the normal rhythm of the heart. So when you understand the normal rhythm of the heart, so now we are going to see about the irregular rhythm of the heart, that is called as the arrhythmia. So here there will be the irregular heartbeat or disturbance in the rhythm of the heart, that is called as the arrhythmia. So here heart may be fast, so there will be a faster heart rate, or there may be a slow heartbeat, and at the same time there will be the extra beat in between the one normal beat will be seen in the particular individual, or there may be a chance of missed beat in the one some normal individual. So these are the some of the arrhythmia conditions. So arrhythmia, it is classified into two classifications. So that is according to the heart rate. So if the heart rate is above 100 beats per minute, then it is called as the tachycardia. So the tachycardia is nothing but the if the heart rate is 100 beats per above minute, then it is called as tachycardia, and if it is bradycardia, then the heartbeat should be 60 beats per minute. So if it is below 60 beats per minute, then it is called as bradycardia. So if the normal rhythm of the heart should be in between 60 to 100 beats per minute. So these are the two major classifications of the irregular rhythm of the heart, that is arrhythmia, that is tachycardia, and the bradycardia. So according to the SA node, so SA node, if it is a pacemaker, then it is classified into two types, that is the normotypic arrhythmia and the ectopic arrhythmia. So the normotypic arrhythmia is a condition in which SA node, that is the sinoatrial node, is the pacemaker of the normal individual, and in ectopic arrhythmia, so other than the SA node will be acting as a pacemaker. So according to the SA node acting as a pacemaker or not, that is classified into two types, that is the normotypic arrhythmia as well as the ectopic arrhythmia. So if the SA node is the pacemaker, then it is called as the normotypic arrhythmia, and if SA node is not the pacemaker, then it is called as the ectopic arrhythmia. So in today's video we are going to just in brief about the normotypic arrhythmia and the ectopic arrhythmia. So the normotypic arrhythmia is nothing but the irregular heartbeat in which SA node is the pacemaker. So here the SA node is the pacemaker. It is divided into three types, that is the sinus arrhythmia, sinus tachycardia, and the sinus bradycardia. So these are the three classifications of the normotypic arrhythmia. So first we are going to see about the sinus arrhythmia. So here there will be the normal rhythmical increase and decrease in the heart rate in relation to the respiration takes place in the individual. So what happens? So when the person go for inspiration, there will be the increase in the heart rate will be seen in the particular individual. At the same time, when the person goes for expiration, so that is when he exhales out the air, then there will be the decrease in the heart rate will be seen in the particular individual. So that is the sinus arrhythmia. So since it is related with your respirations, so it is also called as the respiratory sinus arrhythmia. So the normal sinus rhythm means the normal heartbeat with SA node as the pacemaker, but here according to your respirations, so there will be the increase and decrease in the heart rate will be seen in the particular individual. So here the ECG changes mainly the duration of the RR interval. So the one in between the RR interval, the duration of the RR interval changes according to the inspiration and the expirations, and that is called as a sinus arrhythmia, and that is the first classification of the normotypic arrhythmia. So next, second one is the sinus tachycardia. So there will be the increase in the discharge of the impulses from the SA node. So the impulses generation from the SA node will be increased, due to which there will be the increase in the heart rate will be seen in the particular individual. So this is in this schematic representation, you can see the two ECGs. So the first ECG indicates the normal ECG and the second one indicates the abnormal ECG. So here the sinus tachycardia is seen because there is a very short RR interval is seen in the particular second ECG. So this indicates the sinus tachycardia. So sinus tachycardia is nothing but the increase in the discharge of the impulses from SA node that results in the increase in the heart rate, and that is called as a sinus tachycardia. So in sinus tachycardia, there is a short RR interval is seen in the particular ECG of the individual. So that is the second major classification of the normotypic arrhythmia. So third one is the sinus bradycardia. So there will be the reduction in the discharge of the impulses from the SA node. So because of the reduction of the discharge of the impulses from the SA node, that results in the decrease in the heart rate. So here there will be the decrease in the heart rate will be seen in the particular individual, and ECG changes you can see in this particular schematic representation. So first picture is the normal ECG, and the second here the RR interval. So the distance between the two RR waves is prolonged. So there is the prolonged RR interval is seen in the particular individual. So that is the major changes you can see in the ECG during the sinus bradycardia. So these are the three major classifications of the normotypic arrhythmia. So second major classification is the ectopic arrhythmia. So here it is the abnormal heartbeat in which other than the SA node becomes the phase maker. So here that is other than the SA node. So in the normal individual, the phase maker of the normal heart or the mammalian heart is the SA node. So in this ectopic arrhythmia, other than the SA node will be acting as a phase maker, and that is called as the ectopic arrhythmia. So it is divided into two types, that is the homotypic arrhythmia and the heterotypic arrhythmia. So the homotypic arrhythmia is nothing but the impulses for the heartbeat arises from the any part of the conductive system. So here what happens, SA node will not be producing any impulses other than the SA node, that is the AV node, either bundle office or the Purkinje fibers will be acting as a phase maker in this particular homotypic arrhythmia, and that will be producing the impulses for the heart rate. So that is the first type division of the ectopic arrhythmia, that is the homotypic arrhythmia. So that is impulses for the heartbeat arises from any part of the conductive system other than the SA node, that is called as the homotypic arrhythmia. And the heterotypic arrhythmia is nothing but the impulses arises from the musculature of the heart other than the conductive system. So other than the conductive system means, so either SA node will not be producing the impulses, or AV node will not be producing the impulses, or bundle of His or the Purkinje fibers will not be producing the impulses other than this conductive system. Other parts of the heart, that is the musculature of the heart, will be producing the impulses for the heart rate, and that is called as the heterotypic arrhythmia. So the heterotypic arrhythmia is nothing but the impulses arises from the musculature of the heart other than the conductive system. So that is called as the ectopic arrhythmia. So the different ectopic arrhythmias, first one is the heart block, That is the blockage of the impulses generated by the SA node in the conductive system. So the SA node will be producing the impulses, but there will be the blockage of the impulses will be seen, and that is the heart block. And extrasystole is nothing but the premature contraction of the heart before its normal contraction. So before producing the normal contraction, there may be one extra beat will be seen in this particular ectopic arrhythmia, that is called as the extrasystole. And third one is the paroxysmal tachycardia. So there will be the sudden attack of increased heart rate due to the ectopic foci arising from the atria, AV node or the ventricle. So what happens? So the one extra impulses will be generated from the either from the atria, AV node or the ventricle, and that causes the extra heartbeat, and that is called as the paroxysmal tachycardia. And fourth one is the atrial flutter. So there is the rapid and ineffective atrial contraction. It is will be seen in the particular individual. It is caused by the ectopic foci arising from the atrial musculature. So the atrial musculature will be acting as a impulse or the pacemaker production, and because of which there will be the ineffective atrial contractions will be seen, and that leads to the atrial flutter. And last two is the atrial fibrillation. So there will be the rapid and irregular atrial contraction will be seen. So here the heart rate will be around 300 to 400 beats per minute. And the last one is the ventricular fibrillations. So here there will be the rapid and irregular twitching of the ventricles takes place. So here there will be the irregular twitching of the ventricle takes place, and that leads to the dangerous cardiac arrhythmia. And these are the some of the ectopic arrhythmia, and in this ectopic arrhythmia, other than the SA node, will be acting as a pacemaker. So these are the some of the arrhythmia conditions in the pathological condition in the particular individual. Yes, thank you.